Folks, Pastor Rocky Branch, hope you're doing great today. Well, we talked about Jonah yesterday. I want to continue with that story a little bit because all of us, from time to time, find ourselves in that situation. If you are a Christian, at some point God has asked you to do something or told you to do something, and at some point in your life you've said no. Well, Jonah was in that same situation. Now, just let me clarify something that's very important. Jonah was working for God. He was serving God. He was doing stuff for God, and God wanted him to do something else. You see, God is going to speak to you to continue your growth as you are working for him. And if you come back to him, supposing that you have been, out of fellowship with God entirely, and you have to pray the prayer of repentance, and you come back to God, well, then he starts the process in you. But in most cases, people that are finding themselves in misdirected areas is that they have been serving the Lord, they've been doing reasonably well, or fair, or maybe okay, and then something comes up, like this thing with Jonah. Well, Jonah didn't want to go because the Ninevites, he didn't like them, and they had been at war with Jerusalem for a long time, and just all sorts of stuff happens. But Jonah then, of course, goes down to Joppa, gets on the ship, goes to Tarshish, now, or tries to go to Tarshish. And the story unfolds kind of rapidly because Jonah is on this boat, and there's a couple of things to think about. When you and I walk away from the direction of God, immediately it gets us in two areas of life. Immediately it becomes expensive for us, spiritually and physically, and not only that, it puts others in danger. I want you to get that. Immediately, it becomes expensive for us, physically and spiritually. And secondly, it puts other people immediately in danger. When you are walking willfully away from God, you are in a situation that is very dangerous. Now, God's mercy is great. We thank God. I praise God for his mercy. Walking away from God is like, well, you've been doing the right thing. Some things have come up that's a little challenging. You feel pressured. You decide, well, you know, a drink's not going to hurt. Maybe not. But that drink turns to two and then to five. And you know in your mind, God says, hey, don't do that. But we supersede the will of God by our own will. Or the fellow that having some problems at home. And he says, I'll click on the computer and watch some pornography. It won't be that bad. Before you know it, there's something that's ignited in him, and he finds himself knowing he should not click on the computer, but he is pulled like a weight, like a fish that's been hooked to the shore. It's like the lady that knows in her mind that even though there's problems at home, she should not open her relationship up to someone else. But even though God is saying, don't do it, we supersede the will of God. See, these are areas where, and many others, by the way, whether it be drugs or too much spending or being critical, you can have a wicked spirit trying to carry a Bible, be judgmental of everyone. So it's important to remember that Jonah goes down to this port and pays, cost him money to get on the boat. He gets on the boat. He goes down in the bottom of the ship. He goes to sleep. And those guys on the boat suddenly have been put in a position where they're surrounded by the wrath of God that is forthcoming because they have a stowaway on the boat, so to speak. Now, he paid the fare, but he's a stowaway from God, he thinks. And as a result of that, the scripture is very clear that they lose about everything they have. The cargo has to go overboard because of the storm that comes up on the ship and all sorts of stuff. Well, the challenging issue today is that, you know, there's some things I'd just rather not do. But that's in the flesh. I have seen things happen in the spirit because minding God, that's phenomenal. That you could not plan it. You could not look back and say, wow, this was going to happen. Nobody would believe it anyway. But God has a way of working things out when you and I become obedient and don't take that liberty that we so enjoy because we think that we're making our own decisions. Well, God knows best for us. We ought to understand that by now, but still sometimes we don't. That doesn't make anybody a terrible or horrible person. It just needs to make us understand that if I start walking away from God, it becomes expensive to me physically and to me spiritually. It's more expensive than I want to pay. It's too expensive to lose the presence of God. There's no money that can buy that back. And then it's dangerous to people around you. Listen, there's no doubt people watching me right now that you have just simply said to God, no. It may not be a moral issue. It may not be some sort of a terrible situation. It may not be an illegal situation. It just may be a comfort situation. No, I'm not going to do that. Well, what happens when that takes place is you put other people in jeopardy. Now, one person says, well, I don't believe in all that. You know, I don't believe that, I don't believe that God's going to punish everybody else. Well, God's not going to punish everybody else. God's going to punish you. And if you involve everybody else, they're in with you. You see, it's very valuable to understand that God loves us. God's not against us. God loves us. And when you have those thoughts, God knows. God wants us as people to work together, to understand each other by His Spirit, have accountability partners, somebody that we can call and talk about stuff before we do it, and get through that little temptation, that little common area that we all face, and be honest enough with somebody that you know loves you, and it's not going to run out and talk about it, and work you through it. Because that journey is not a good one. Jonah went on a journey that wasn't a good journey. So I just want to encourage you today that before you end up in a fish's belly, or before you end up having your friends lose everything because of their investment in you, when you are doing wrong and nobody else knows it, let me encourage you to stop. Let me encourage you to stop right now. Right now. And ask God to forgive you. You can call me. You can send me a message. If I can help you, I will help you. I don't care who you are. And everything I do is private. I'll be glad to help you and pray with you. I don't care what it is. I want you okay. Because Jonah is an example that is very valuable to us as Christians, walking away from the will of God. Well, if you come back, God will bless you for it. God bless you. We love you. And goodbye.